What is happening with the economy? Ray Dalio and the bigger picture. Large wealth gaps, large value gaps, a lot of debt, and economic downturn. This is what Ray Dalio believes is on the economic horizon unless the situation takes a turn for the better. Hello everyone and welcome back to Investing with Antoinette. You can call me even Tony. Recently, I came across a very, very interesting interview with Ray Dalio. And in today's video, we are going to take a look at what he said together. Please remember to hit the thumbs up button and share the video with your friends if you really enjoy my content. If you would like to see more of the same, go ahead and subscribe if you haven't already done it. So, Ray Dalio, founder of Bridgewater, believes that they are in for some rough times unless the economy recovers to a place where it's good for most people. And if I have to be honest, it is difficult to disagree with the notion, especially if you look at it from his point of view. But what is Bridgewater? Oh, just the largest hedge fund in the world, valued at over $150 billion in the assets that it trades with. So, I believe it is safe to assume that the founder of such an establishment has a decent idea what he is talking about. You see, Ray Dalio has a thing for history and patterns in history. He spends a great deal of time studying historical financial data and market patterns. And when someone with his background says the four sentences that I quoted at the beginning of this video, then there is a probably good reason. Let's talk about values gap. With this, Ray Dalio doesn't mean value in financial terms, but human values and principles. The divide between people, the wounds, is growing deeper. People were starting to look at everything in terms for us and them, or even worse, us against them. Political ideologies, ideals, life and life philosophies, and just about everything else. This creates a ton of tension, and it's very harmful for the economy. What about wealth gap? The wealth gap in the world today is wider than it's ever been. The health crisis and the lockdowns also contributed to the problem. A lot of small and medium-sized businesses were hurt really badly by the lockdown. And countless people lost their jobs. Things are looking pretty grim for everyone, but the richest people, the top 10 wealthiest billionaires, managed to actually gain a combined total of over $540 billion. As you can imagine, this places an even greater strain on the already tense economic climate. Or, as Ray Dalio puts it, it makes the entire system very shaky. The debt. And when I say debt, I don't just mean individual debt. I am talking about debt on a national level across the board. US national debt, for example, it's over $25 trillion. And yes, this is much higher than their GDP. They are so deep on debt that even if they took every single penny that was generated during 2020 on trying to pay it off, it still wouldn't be enough. Yes, that's right. Dalio is worried that the situation we are looking at could potentially be worse than what the economy went through back in 2008. We've got the Federal Reserve printing a ton of money that just gets pushed into the economy in an unnatural ways, remaking matters worse into the long run. Of course, they are doing what they're doing because it allows them to patch up things at the short term. But the economy can't keep going on with band-aid solutions. They need to start thinking about the long term, or the world may find itself in the middle of a huge crisis. The US has a massive debt that it needs to cover. The people who lost their jobs need to be provided with financial aid. Businesses need to be provided with the loans. The worst part is that the Fed can't stop doing any of these things, or the situation will get even worse. They need more money, but the economy can't provide them. What is the solution? Print more money, inject them into the economy, and hope that things get better before they get worse. A band-aid solution and a flimsy one at the best. Ray Dalio warns that this is not the natural or intended way to finance things. The money is meant to come from producing more and selling more. That is what taxes are really for. One of the ways in which the government introduces new money into the economy is by using bonds. They are supposed to allow individuals and institutions to buy stuff. However, there is another problem here. Ray Dalio pointed out that there are more bonds and other assets that can be sold than there is money to actually cover them. Or, in his words, these claims on those bonds are far greater than what would be allowed to happen. This is not a recent thing, he said. You can go back thousands of years and see the same pattern. Of course, this doesn't make it a good pattern. It's very bad and very dangerous pattern, both for the economy and for the dollar itself. And yes, I know that most people are 100% convinced that the dollar is going to remain the currency, but there are no real guarantees for that, especially with the current economic situation on mine. As a matter of fact, the US dollar is severely weakened in comparison to the pound, the Australian dollar, and the Chinese yen. The fact shows that the flat is rapidly losing its positions, in no small part thanks to the Fed's printing around the health crisis. If something doesn't change soon, we could actually see the US losing its reserve currency status in the near future. Ray Dalio warns that the current situation reminds him of what was happened during the 1930s. The financial dynamic is the same. The polarization is the same. Wealth, values, politics. There is a great power on the rise, China. And yet, in case you missed the memo, China is an economic powerhouse. Their economy is growing almost three times as fast as that for the US, 6.7% versus 2.25%. They've got a much larger population, about four times larger than that one of the USA. And to top it all off, they've also got a lot less debt to worry about, four times smaller debt and two times smaller governmental debt. Some economists have also come out and said that they expect China's economy to overtake that of the US by 2028. And in closing, I just want to point out that I didn't make this video to bring you down or make you worried. No. My goal here is to help people stay in the loop on the top of things. I also believe that all of this is really interesting and can definitely serve as a practical example of why we cannot afford to ignore the importance of history. And if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to let me know with a thumbs up, or and feel free to leave questions and ideas about the future videos in the comment section down below. And thank you for watching, and until next time, stay very, very motivated.